It cannot be! The king cannot be dead!
Sir Cyrus, I share your pain, but we must accept this. Sadly, we are the only ones who can hold this kingdom together. Think of Balandor.
Sarvain, you do not share my pain. The king was like a father to me. He cared for me since I was a child. There is no Balandor without King Valdos.
Ours is not the only leader lost. Do not forget, sir, that Archduke Dalam of Faria is also dead. It is very likely that Faria will hold Balandor accountable for the Archduke's murder. Presumably, their governing council is still dominated by the war faction. We must prepare the city for an almost certain invasion. Though it pains me greatly to say it, we have no time for grief. For now, we have two priorities. Rescue Princess Cisna and restore the kingdom. Put your sadness aside and remember, your duty as captain of the castle guard comes before your personal emotions. As for the boy, Leonard, if I'm not mistaken, you hold the Knight's Ark and know how to control its power. That means you have made a pact with the Knight.
Me? A pact?
It is said that the Knight is a weapon of war, crafted long, long ago by our predecessors, the Ancients. In their writings, they referred to it as the Incorruptus. When the great cataclysm 17 years ago opened the ground, long buried ruins were uncovered. Among them was the temple in which the Knight was found. We recovered it, and brought it here, to the treasure vault. The king's scholars and scientists spent years studying the artifact, but for all their poking and prodding, they were never able to unlock its secrets. What we learned was that only people the Knight deems worthy have the right to wield its power. These are the Knight's pactmakers. The ancient books would tell us no more than that.
Sarvain, he's just a boy.
Hey, don't ask me how I unlocked it. I just did.
Then the Knight has chosen you, lad, and there must be a reason. But that is a question for a later time, I'm afraid. Right now, I have a far more important task to set before you. You must hurry after the princess at once, and use the Knight's power to rescue her from her captors.
Hmm?
Are you mad?
Just a darn minute. Leonard isn't part of the royal army. Why send him?
The circumstances demand it. The villains who attacked us are part of a group who worship the Ancients. We call them the Magi, because it is ancient magic they use to summon forth their vicious beasts. They are powerful, but not powerful enough to stand against your Knight.
So what? Solve your own problems.
Pardon?
Yuli, it's okay. I'll do it.
What? But...
She needs me. If I can help, I want to.
I am glad. Your kingdom will be grateful.
Then it's settled, is it? We'd best hurry. The longer we tarry here, the further away they'll get.
And you are?
The name's Aldor. Just a humble traveler. I can swing a sword and cast the odd spell or two. I'd wager I can be of help. Surely you weren't gonna send him alone.
Then allow me to join you.
No, impossible. Your place is in the capital. I will need you and your men to help control the populace. People are frightened. With both the king and princess gone, you must be there to reassure them.
And leave it to strangers to decide the princess's fate?
Whatever must be done. War with the Magi began the moment they beset the castle. Sir Cyrus, we must prepare to defend the realm.
Sarvain! Very well.
We leave on the morrow. Tonight, we rest in town. I sent out one of these Bigelows to follow the princess. As we journey, we'll keep us informed of exactly where she is. Always.
The bird will find the princess for us?
Two birds, Leonard. A pair of Bigelows can communicate speech and images over long distances.
That's some trick.
It appears that the princess has been taken east toward the Nordia tunnels. We must follow her there. But first we should avail ourselves of the town's shops and prepare for the journey. It's going to be a long one.
Please, Sisna, be safe.